I feel that almost everyone requires what we call as positive strokes, a sort of feeling that, you know, I am wanted, I am appreciated, I am acknowledged. There may be a few, very few people who are so self-centered and so egoistic maybe, who, to whom it doesn't matter what other people say. But barring such people, almost everybody, right, from a small child to a very old grandfather, from a very ordinary poor person to the richest and the most reputed person, every one of us, sometime or the other, has this need that we must be appreciated, we must be acknowledged, and things of that sort. Unfortunately, what happens is that many a time, because of this need, some unscrupulous people try to take advantage and flatter. Flattering is telling somebody something which is not really true, just to get some mileage out of him, or for whatever may be the reason. But let's understand that most of us can make out when somebody is flattering and when somebody is saying something genuinely nice. So now let's come to what positive strokes are. Positive stroke is an identification, acknowledgement, and appreciation of something good in that human being. It could be a general characteristic, like you're a very helpful person, you're very nice, and you know, you have a good smiling face, or anything of that sort. Or it could be something very specific. You were so nice to me yesterday when I was not feeling well, or when I needed help at that moment, or something. So either way, a positive stroke has to be genuine. Now, a positive stroke can be verbal and non-verbal. It could be a pat, it could be a hug, it could be a smile from a distance, it could be a thumbs up, it could be just about anything. But a few words added to a positive stroke always has a deeper meaning, because the words resonate and, you know, they sort of remain in your mind. In counseling, there is definitely a need for positive. I would consider that as one of the basic skills required to be a good counselor. As a counselor, you need to be able to develop that practice and habit of giving positive strokes. Generally, we are not used to doing it because we are a little scared. What will the other person think? Will he think that I am flattering him? Will it look a little awkward or embarrassing? No. As long as you are genuine, it will not look bad, it will not look embarrassing, nothing of that sort. And remember that in counseling, positive strokes are needed at every possible stage. When a person comes to meet you for the first time, a simple, nice, positive stroke makes him want to build rapport with you and makes him want to talk to you. When the counselee is pouring out and talking something, one odd little small positive stroke helps him to keep up with the flow. If he gets stuck when he's talking and he doesn't know what to do, a positive stroke saying that, so far you've explained very nicely to me. It's good to see that despite all that you're going through, you are, you know, still having a smile on your face. These are the type of positive strokes which help a person to overcome when he is stuck and when he wants to again proceed with his talk. Similarly, when the person ends his whatever he had to tell you, that's another time when the person needs some positive strokes as a sort of winding up process. Then, when you're closing a session, for example, when you're letting the person go, leave him with a positive stroke that remains as a very positive thing in his mind, something for him to carry home or take home, as we say. Positive strokes are very important when you're doing goal setting with the counselee, when you're helping the person to actually take some decisions or move ahead in life or something of that sort. That's when, if you give him that reinforcement that yes, you are capable of doing things, you will find that the person will become more determined, more motivated to set whatever goals and work towards them. And then, of course, leave a person with positive strokes and you are winding up a counseling process. Then you want to empower the person and let him loose and say, okay, now that you have overcome whatever issues you had come with, move on in life, have a nice time, be good, and then I'm always there for you. That is a time when a final positive stroke leaves him with a very warm feeling that yes, I have found a very true, genuine friend whom I can always come back to, but I am capable enough of running my own life and I shall proceed. This is what we shall see practically by some very small, very simple demonstrations which will drive home the point to you as to what positive strokes are and how they can be given.